friends of ours, I should say. Mother had passed away, and we was in New Orleans to the funeral on yesterday. We was at the funeral on yesterday, but we back. Somebody said, who is we? This is Bishop Nixon, and this is the Spirit of the Living God. Excuse me, speaking to the hearts and minds of people to let them know where you're at. It's not where God's trying to take you to, and what you're going through, what you're dealing with right now, that's not the end of the story. See, because a lot of times the devil, what he does, he play up on your mind. He make you feel like nobody love you, nobody care anything about you, have you over in a corner feeling sorry for yourself. But I'm telling you, in this day and hour which we're living in, it's time for a breakout. Are you listening to me? You can't be complacent in the place that you are at. You have to make up your mind. You have to make up in your mind that I'm not going to stay where I'm at. But God is constantly changing my story. God is constantly taking me from one level to another level, from glory to glory, and from faith to faith. How is God changing my story? Because God is changing my mind. Some of the things that used to get me down, some of the things that made me feel defeated, some of the things that make me feel like giving up. Now you know what those things are. Those things just a stepping stone for me to go just a little bit higher, just to get a little bit closer to God. Because it is my belief and it is my conviction that what won't destroy you will make you stronger. And so you have to start learning that, speaking over your life and say, I am getting stronger because God is taking me to a place I've never been before, that I can experience some things that I never experienced before in my life. All right, because why? This is a year of our upgrade, amen? I know a lot of people, they don't receive that. A lot of people cannot get that in their spirit. They cannot get that in their mind. But I want you to realize that this is our year. Our year for what? For upgrade. God wants to upgrade us in every area of our life. I'm talking about spiritual, physically, mentally, emotionally. I say, this is your hour. This is your season for an upgrade. But you know, the enemy won't make you think that you're stuck. The enemy won't make you think that you'll never get past where you're at. Have you ever been in a place where you were in a vehicle and looked like you were stuck and looked like the more that you mashed on the gas, the more you put it in drive, the more you tried to accelerate, look like the deeper that you was going? But I come to help you get unstuck today because there is a word from the Lord. There is a word out of Zion. You know what the Bible said? The Bible said, know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. But the only truth gonna make you free is the truth that you apply to your life. And that's the reason why I be on here on weekdays from Monday through Saturdays. You know why I'm on here? That you can get just a little bit wiser, that you can get just a little bit closer, that you can have just a better relationship with your God. At the end of the day, it's not the relationship we have with people as much as it is with God. Because when you get the right relationship with God, God will put the right people in your path that you have the right relationship with people. I just said enough for somebody to get excited. Thank God for Mother Keller coming on. God bless her. I want to go to the prayer request list. And as soon as we go through the prayer request list, then we are going to go before the Lord in prayer. And I tell you where I'm going to do this. I want to welcome you, first of all, to the Voice of Pentecostal Truth, Apostolic Doctrine, Teaching and Preaching, Holiness as a Lifestyle. Don't believe in denomination, because all denomination does is divide people. Thank God for Sister Nancy Ata Nixon coming on. God bless you. Let me say that one more time. Don't believe in denomination, because all denomination is divine. And the devil, the Bible said, the thief cometh but to steal, to kill, and to destroy. The Lord said, I come that you may have life and that you may have it more abundantly. In other words, God wants to walk in abundant life. You ought to claim that over your life right now. I'm not going to be walking in poverty any longer. I'm not going to be lacking, walking in lack any longer. But from this day forward, I decree and declare that I'm going to be walking in abundance. Somebody ought to give God a shout right there. Somebody ought to give God a praise right there. Now, the reason why I can decree and declare that over my life, because the Lord said, above all things, he wished that we may prosper and be in health, even as our soul shall prosper. And so what God is telling us, I want that soulish man to prosper. And when that soulish man prosper, my health and my wealth gonna break forth. Oh, God, I want to let you know that God gonna bring us a stream out of a desert. God gonna make us a path out of the wilderness. My God, I'm excited. I'm excited about what God is doing. And so I want to do this just a little bit different. I want to call the people's name in their situation that they're dealing with as we pray. And so I need you to have your paper and pen, a paper and pencil. I want you to be ready to write the names down as I call them as we go before the throne of grace. And also I need you with your paper and pen because there are some scriptures we're going to give you. You know why we give you scripture? Because the Bible says, study, show thyself approved unto God. A workman not be made ashamed, but write the divine word of truth. I want you to write this word down, go back in your devotional time, and study this word for yourself. Because I want you to say, Bishop Nixon said, Pastor Nixon said, Brother Nixon said, I want you to be able to say, the Lord says. Are you listening to me? I want you to be able to say, the Lord said. And so at this time, prepare your hearts and your mind to pray. I want my intercessors on your praying. I want my prayer warriors on your praying because people are in trouble. This world is in trouble. This nation is in trouble. But the Bible said that the prayers of the righteous avail much. So let us pray at this time. And I want to remind you once again that the music that you hear playing in the background, we do not own the rights to this music. Gracious Father, even now we humble ourselves in thy sight because in you, God, we live, move, and have our being. And without you, we are nothing. We come before you, God, confessing all of our sins, God, the sins of omission, commission, God. And we pray that you forgive, blot out every iniquity in our life. And we pray that you create within us a clean heart, renew a right spirit on the inside of us. And God, because we come not leaning to our own understanding, we acknowledge you in all of our ways. Because in you, God, we live, we move, and we have our being. And God, we pray right now for the healing of this nation. We pray, God, for all of our spiritual leaders, all of our apostles, prophets, pastors, teachers, evangelists, all of our bishops, God. We pray for them right now, God, that you continue. Take them through this spiritual metamorphosis. Clothe their mind with wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. Clothe them with holy boldness, God. And let them speak the word, God. Let this word be like a sword. Let this word, God, I'm talking about cut the manner to the manner of the bone. Let this word, God, be like a hammer that breaks rocks into pieces. And God, we pray for all of our political leaders, all of the ones that are in political positions of authority. God, we pray right now that you transform their minds out of the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of your dear son, Jesus. And God, we pray right now that we come against every stubborn spirit, every rebellious spirit that may be in political office. God, we pray for all against all the insurrectionists. God, we pray for all the racist groups, all of the terrorist groups. God, we pray against the Bloods, the Crips, M13. God, we pray against the KKK. We pray right now in the name of Jesus Christ against the skinhead, white supremacist, God. We pray against the Proud Boys. We pray right now in the name of Jesus against all of these terrorist groups. And God, we pray that you dispose of them by any means necessary. And God, we pray for mercy, grace, and healing over this prayer request list right now. In the name of Jesus, God, we pray for Sister Danielle Keller Coleman and her son Mason, God, that you deliver them from COVID-19. And God, we pray for Sister Hannah Grimes, God, that you deliver from COVID-19. And God, we pray for complete healing and Brother Roger Dunn's body, Sister Lucy Holmes, God. We pray, God, for complete healing. We pray, God, for Sister Jackie Floyd. And we pray, God, that she be made whole. We pray, God, for Sister Deborah Brown, who's suffering from lymphedema. and swelling of the intestines. God, we speak to this problem in our body. We curse this disease, this infirmity in our body. We curse it at the root, the core, and the cause of it. And we cast it out right now in the name of Jesus. And God, we pray for a speedy recovery of Mr. Randy Rishi from knee surgery, God. We pray, God, for Sister Erica Barnes, complete recovery from the surgery, God. We pray for Brother Anthony Watkins Jr., 6-year-old that dealing with autism. And God, we decree and declare by Jesus' stripes, he's healed and made whole. We pray, God, for Brother Adrian Devlin's complete healing, complete deliverance. We pray for Brother Terry Tate Jr., God, heal him from COVID-19. And God, we pray right now for Brother Connor Warren, God, the young man that had explosion of fireworks that exploded, God, deformed his body, his eyes. God, we pray right now for this young man's eye. The doctor said he may not recover. We pray right now for complete healing of his eyes in the name of Jesus. God, we pray right now for my wife, for my mother, for the Way of Holiness Church ministry, for all of our elders, ministers, all of our deacons, God. We pray not only for them, but we pray for their wives, their families, and their spouses right now in the name of Jesus. And God, I pray for everyone that's on you with us by live streaming. We decree and declare both spiritual and financial breakthroughs. And God, we pray for all of our Kenyan brothers, all of our followers out of the UK, all of our followers out of Pakistan, Afghanistan, God, for spiritual and financial breakthroughs. And they're live right now. And I decree by faith, God, that it's done. And God, we pray for unity, love, and peace among all of the body of Christ. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank God. I need you to speak it over your own life. Thank God for Elder Ford coming on. Thank God for Evangelist Mackin. Thank God for Terry Drake. Shout it like you mean it, saints. Open your mouth, saints. Shout it like you mean it. That God is changing my story. I'm talking about right now. I'm not talking about tomorrow. He's changing my story. Mm-hmm. That won't be your story no more. Poverty won't be your story no more. Sickness and from disease won't be your story no more. It won't be my story no more. All right, all right, all right. All right, people of God, brothers and sisters, ladies and gentlemen. It's time for us what to get just a little bit wiser. Why? Because the Bible says that wisdom is the principal thing. The Bible says, with all you're getting, get understanding. Please pray for all of our spiritual leaders. Thank God for Sister Cheryl Cummins, Lindsay coming on. God bless you, Sister Cheryl. Praise God. I was looking for you to show up in one of our services. Amen. This weekend. But we appreciate you. You are so faithful for being on. You're with us. And we want you to know that we love you with the love of Christ. My God, my God. I hope and pray I'm helping somebody. Are you listening to me? I hope and pray I'm helping somebody. I hope and pray I am encouraging somebody. I don't want to think that the work that I'm doing is in vain. Now, I want y'all to pray for the organization which I am a part of. That's the Pentecostal Assembly of the World. We want you to pray for our presiding bishop. And we want to pray for everybody to make up the PFW, their whole staff. We want to pray for the Louisiana District Council, in which I am the chairman. We want to pray for our diocese bishop, Bishop James E. Daniel, everybody that make up the LDC. Are you listening to me? And so you know what I'm all about. I'm all about Pentecostal truth, apostolic doctrine, and teaching and preaching holiness as a lifestyle and not denomination. So I want you to like, tag, and tell somebody, let somebody know that the voice of Pentecostal truth and apostolic doctrine is on the air, teaching, preaching, and reaching the world for Christ. You know what I'm all about, edifying. I'm trying to edify everybody that's on here. That is, provide both moral and intellectual instruction. I'm on here to educate. That is to bring forth what is within your full potential, that you become the leader that God is calling for in this last hour. We're on here to, excuse me, We're on here to empower people. That's why I'm talking to you. I'm talking to you and I'm talking to you. We're on here to empower you. And you know, we're talking about to empower you. That is to bring forth, my God, my God. I'm talking about to make you stronger, make you more confident, especially in controlling your life and claiming your rights as a child of God. I know I'm talking right. I'm talking to somebody. This may not be for everybody, but it is for somebody. And you ought to claim this word right now. So like, tag, and share. Let everybody know that one of the last of your old school prophets teaching and preaching the unadulterated word of God, not for the love of money, not for fame or for glory, but that God will be glorified, the saints will be edified, Satan will be horrified and terrified, backsliders will be restored, sinners will be saved and delivered. Don't forget, like, tag, and share. Let everybody know it's time for an upgrade. God want to upgrade you. I'm talking about spiritually, physically, mentally, emotionally. God want to upgrade you also financially. In Jesus' name. Why? Because this is the year. This is the year of the manifestation of your expectation. I'm talking about the year of 2022. Every once in a while, I have to go back and rehearse this. Because, you know, 2021, I just kept telling the church, kept telling the saints, I just kept telling them that the best was yet to come. That was in 2021. Are you with me? But now we stepped out of 2021, we stepped into 2022. And I told them that the year of 2022 was going to be our year of upgrade. And you know why I said this? Let me give you some scripture. Thank God for Sister Elena Smith coming on. God bless you. We appreciate you. Thank God for Minister Armstrong coming on. Let me explain to you why we was talking about 2022 is the year of upgrade. I want to take you to Jeremiah 29 and 10. Please write these scriptures down. Go back in your devotional time and study these scriptures. The Bible says, "For thus said the Lord, that after 70 years be accomplished at Babylon, I would visit you and perform my good word toward you and causing you to return to this place." Now we understand that there was a prophetic word that God spoke to the children of Israel because of their disobedience. They had been taken captivity down in Babylon. But God let them know, after 70 years, I'm coming to visit you. Now, how do that apply to you and I? I don't care how many times you have fallen short. I don't care how many times you have failed. I don't care how many times. As long as you have breath in your body, God yet can visit you. All you need to do is repent, confess, and come to God with a broken and a contrite heart. And he'll do you like he did the children of Israel that was in captivity in Babylon. God said, "Not only I'm going to visit you, I'm going to perform my good word towards you." My God. Look at verse number 11 of the 29th chapter of the book of Jeremiah. Thank God for Deacon Elmo Lewis coming on. God bless you, Deacon. Amen. We send love to you and your family. The Bible says, "For I know the thoughts that I think towards you." I need y'all to get this. Because I'm talking about the year of upgrade, right? I'm trying to take you to where we get this from. Because we have to understand that the Old Testament is the New Testament concealed. But the New Testament is the Old Testament revealed. See, there are some things that God spoke to our ancestors, our spiritual ancestors, Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, spoke through the mouth of the prophets, the priests, the judges. But that word is yet alive for you and I. And I take this word that come out of the mouth of the prophet Jeremiah. He said, "For I know the thoughts I think toward you, saith the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end." Lord Jesus, I feel like shouting right there. Because God said, "Gonna give us an expected end. Then shall you call upon me, and you shall go and pray unto me, and I would hearken unto you, and you shall seek me and find me when you shall search for me with all your heart. That word is alive and well today. Are you with me? Now, God said, I'm going to do my part. Can I take my time and deal with this again? God said, I'm going to do my part. I'm going to come back and visit you. I'm going to perform my good word towards you. I'm going to cause you to return to the place. Now, the place where you were at, it may not just be a physical place God wants to return you to. There may be a spiritual place that you have fallen from. But God said, this is what I want to do. I want to return you to this place. Now, we understand when he's talking to the children of Israel, he was talking about returning to the place in which he had given them to them. Then God said, I know the thoughts that God said, I know the way I think about you. I know how I love you. God said, this is the way I think towards you. You know, people say all kinds of crazy things about you, to you, and especially family members, because family members sometimes could be the one that hurt you the worst. I'm talking about loved ones. I'm talking about spouses and parents and children can hurt you the most. But that's not like God. God said, I know the thoughts I think towards you. So I want you to stop thinking the way you think. The Bible said, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. The Bible said, God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. So if God loved us that much, I need y'all to catch this. If God loved us that much, don't you let the devil tell you a misfit. Don't you let the devil tell you things not gonna work out for you. Don't you let the devil tell you that you're gonna be a foothold for the enemy. Because the Bible said, greater is he that's in you than he that's in the world. Now, let me go back and deal with this. You know, I get carried off and I get carried away and I get excited because I'm excited about what God's next move is. Listen to me. I'm excited about what God's next move is. So you know what I come to tell y'all today? Put a smile on your face. Remember what the Bible says. Lift up your head, all your gates, even lift them up, your everlasting door. And the King of glory shall come in. Who is this King of glory? He is the Lord of hosts. He's mighty. Fight my battle. So I don't have to fight my battle because the Lord is going to fight my battle. Somebody ought to give God a shout out there with me today. Thank God for Sister Cardell Curtis coming on. God bless you, baby. Amen. We appreciate you. Catch this. Catch this. We're reading out of Jeremiah chapter 29, verse number 11. Thank God for Brother Raymond Dunn coming on. Now, forget about what people say about you. Forget about what people think about you. People can be cruel. People can be low down and dirty. Forget about what people did to you. The Bible says, forget those things which behind, press forward to the mark of a high calling of God in Christ Jesus. Thank God for Evangelist Woodall coming on. Are you with me? If we continue to think about the past, what God was doing to the children of Israel, in the 29th chapter of the book of Jeremiah, starting in verse number 10, they've been in captivity for 70 years because of rebellion and disobedience. But God said, I will visit you. I want you to put that in today's vernacular that God, I might have fallen short. I might have disobeyed. I may have walked away from you, but you're talking to me right now that you can come visit me. The thing I like about him, when he come and visit you, your life will never be the same. He'll change your story. Because the Bible says he wrote a book on our life. And I know that my God don't write nothing but bestseller. Now, catch this, catch this. Because we're talking to the children of Israel, but I want you to put this in today's vernacular. And I want you to receive this word like God is talking to me. Now, he said, I'm going to visit you. If you're in a place by yourself where you can repeat this, I want you to repeat this out of your mouth. The Lord is going to visit me. He's going to perform his good word toward me. He's going to cause me to return to the place that he have already prepared for me. May it be spiritual or natural place. He know the thoughts that he think toward me. Take it personal. The thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give me an expected end. I want you to repeat this. I will call upon him. I will go and pray unto him. I will hearken unto him, and he will hearken unto me. Catch this. Because verse number 13 says, you shall seek me and find me when you shall search for me with all your heart. Lord Jesus, help me. The Lord said, if you search for him with all your heart, you'll find him. Whatever it is you're lacking in your life. Let's go to 2 Corinthians 1 and 20. I have to move on. But I need to drop a few scriptures in your spirit. On a Thursday afternoon, I'm going to give you a word that can prepare you to your destiny. I'm going to give you a mind-changing word that going to change your life. The things that used to get you down, this word going to help you. This word going to heal you. This word going to deliver you. There are some people may not be out there physically sick, but they'll be mentally, emotionally, and spiritually sick. This word going to heal you. They may be going through a financial crisis. This word going to help you. Because this is the year of the upgrade. All right, catch this. Catch this. 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verse number 20. For all the promises of God in him are yea. And in him, amen. Unto the glory of God by us. God, Lord Jesus, don't let me shout right here. Because you know when I think about what's on record over, 3,000 to 7,000 promises? That God left on record for us. The reason why we don't have the promises that God promised us, because we don't go and study what God promised us. The Bible says, by Jesus' stripes, you're healed. Now I take that two ways. I take that in two different ways. Because everybody think about, when you think about healing, Let me break it down to you this way. When King Nebuchadnezzar made the decree, there's the sound of the sackbut and the flute and the harp. All of these instruments, when they are played, he said when they are sounded, everybody had to bow down to the music. Let me help you with it. Let me bring it to your day. The devil wants you to bow down to the lust of the eyes, the lust of the flesh, and the pride of life. But God is about to give you a word to make you stand. I'm talking about through hard times. I'm talking about through tough times. Now, listen to it. The Bible said that the king had made this decree, and when the decree was made, it could not be altered. When the music played, everybody had to bow down. But Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they told the king, we're not careful to answer thee concerning this matter. The God that we serve is able. So that's what I come to tell you today. He's able to help you, lift you, strengthen you, deliver you, heal you. He's able to give you victory. Catch this. Then they said, if he don't do it, he's yet able. Now, catch this. Then they turn around and say, he will. You ought to speak that over your life right now. He will deliver me out of thine hand. When the devil get to working on your body and your body working, racking with pain, when the enemy start talking to your mind and tell you that you're going to die, you need to open up your mouth, decree and declare, that I shall not die, but live, that I can proclaim the works of the Lord. Now, catch what the Hebrew boy said. If he don't do it, he's yet able. But then they spoke with the spirit of positive affirmation, and he will deliver. Catch this. If he delivers out of thine hand, O king, we'll deliver. We die in the fire, we yet deliver. Sister Ariel, God bless you, baby. We appreciate you. Did you get that? No matter what situation you're in, no matter what you're dealing with, no matter what you're going through, the enemy want to make you think that that's the end of the story. So now if I'm sick, if I'm on my bed of affliction, if it looked like the doctor walked over my bed and say, Bishop Nixon, you're going to die. You're not going to live. Now, how can I take that and use that in a positive manner? First of all, what I'm going to say, for me to live is Christ. For me to die is gain. Second of all, I'm going to talk about how precious it is in the death of one of his saints. Third of all, I'm going to say, for me to live is Christ, for me to die is gain. Fourth of all, I'm going to say, if I leave this place, he got a better place prepared for me. Thank God for Sister Annie Halsey. Now, catch this. Because if the Hebrew boys would have died in the fire, they would have gone home to be with the Lord. They would have been delivered. But look at God. They threw the three of them in the fire. The king rose up early in the morning. The king looked in the fire. He said, did not we throw three in the fire? They said, that's right, king. He said, but behold, I see a fourth one walking around in the fire. And the fourth one looked like the Son of God. My God, I feel like shouting right now. Why? Because no matter what trial you're dealing with, no matter what test you're going with, I don't care if you're down in the valley of despair and it looked like there is no hope. I don't care if they cast you in the lion's den. I don't care if they cast you in the burning fiery furnace. I want you to know that Jesus will step in the fire with you. Who feel like shout with me today? I'm excited. I'm excited about what God has done. Thank God for Evangelist King coming on. Thank God for Sister Joyce Marie Lee Williams coming on. God bless you, Sister Joyce. Thank God for Brother Ed Coach coming on. Are you listening to me? Now, so we have to understand. We have to understand that God is with us, that God is fighting for us. When God began to deal with the children of Israel, when he began to deal with Hezekiah, what was the word he gave? You have no need to fight in this battle because the battle is not yours, but the battle belongs to God. So a lot of people are out there trying to fight their own battle. Are you listening to me? But God say, look, cast all your cares upon me because I cared for you. And so when we put ourselves in a position where we say, God, look, all the things that are in my control, I'll take care of that. But all the things that are beyond my control, that's yours. Are you with me? And so when we talk about 2022, I want to get you to this point where we was talking about this is the year of the upgrade. The number 2022 have three vibration of two, multiplying his properties in this number. Thank God for Sister Angie Dumas coming on. It only makes sense that 2022 means balance, faith, success, manifesting miracles, and new opportunities. Stay with me now, because I'm going back over this one more time so you can get it. 2022 means balance. God wants you to have some balance in your life. Our lives, a lot of people's lives is out of balance. I'm talking about the body of Christ. I'm not talking about the world because the world do what the world do. But a lot of us that say we're saved, our life is out of balance because we're partaker of worldly activity more than we are the things of the kingdom. The Bible says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and everything else shall be added unto you. I know I'm talking right. So now God is sending me to tell you that the year of 2022, thank God for Sister Ann, that maiden coming on, God bless you, we love you. God is sending me to tell you the year of 2022 is the year that you need to get your life back balanced. We can't be so worldly that we forget that God called us to holiness. We can't be so spiritual that we do not enjoy some of the things that God has for us. But we get to the point where we indulge in all of these worldly activities. We forget to fast. We forget to pray. When God began to bless us a little bit, we indulge in all of the things that God blesses us with and forget that everything that we have come from God. That's why every day you ought to pray. Every day you ought to seek God. Every day you ought to study this word. Every day you ought to be praying and seeking God. I'm talking about for a spiritual revival to take place in your soul. Now, so this is the year of upgrade. So 2022 means balance. God wants to get our life back balanced because our lives are out of balance. We love to go out and eat. We love to go to the mall shop. We love to go to the ball game. We love to indulge in going to the movies. We love all of these things. Thank God for Deacon Williams coming on. God bless you, Deacon. We love to do all of these things. But the Bible says, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. In the New Testament, the Bible said they went from the house to house daily, breaking bread and in prayer. The Bible said they went up to the temple in prayer on a daily basis. But we're so involved in the things of the world that we forget what God told us. God told us first seek the kingdom of God. Then God told us to seek the righteousness of God. Then God said, everything else you need, I'm going to add it to you. I know I'm talking right. All I need is somebody to shout with me. Now, catch this. If I can get past this, Lord Jesus, I'd go a little bit further. Thank God for Reverend Amar Nazari. If I can get past this, the reason why we decreed and declare that 2022 was the year of the upgrade. 2022 means balance. Somebody open their mouth right there and say, my life gonna get back in balance. I'm gonna spend time with God. Now catch this now. If you only gave God 10% of your time, if you gave God 10% of your time, that'll be 2 hours and 40 minutes a day. Are y'all listening to me? Now, we don't feel like this is important, but we need to spend some time with God. I'm talking about in our closet. I'm not literally talking about a literal closet. I'm talking about the place where you and God go have fellowship. I don't know about y'all, but every morning I get up, I like to spend time with God in the shower. Oh, Jesus. I just talk to him. People be saying, well, when Bishop get in the shower, it might be 30 minutes to an hour before he get out. But what they don't understand, that is my prayer closet. I get in there and have the water running over my body and I'm talking to my God and my God talking to me. When I rise up and come out that shower, I feel like a brand new person. I feel like that this is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and I'll be glad in it. Now, let's go back to 2022. Somebody shout it. Put it on the screen in all capital letters that this is the year of the upgrade. Uh-huh. Now, 2022 means balance. It means faith. What do I tell y'all just about every day? That God wants to take us from faith to faith, from glory to glory. God wants to take us through a spiritual metamorphosis. In other words, God wants to continue to grow spiritually every day of our lives. Are you listening to me? Now, the Bible says, faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. The Bible says, how can you hear without the preacher? How can it preach except they've been sent? So 2022 also means the year of faith. Now, when I studied the scriptures, I only saw two ways that your faith is going to be built up. By listening to a man or woman of God proclaiming the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. Because the Bible says faith comes by hearing. The only other way that your faith is going to excel, your faith is going to the next level. Your faith gonna take you to the place where your money can't take you, where your friends can't take you, where your connection can't take you. The Bible say, Jude said, build up your most holy faith by praying in the Holy Ghost. Paul said, I pray with understanding, but Paul also said, I pray with tongues. When I pray with understanding, the natural man understands. But the spiritual man, when I pray in tongues, now the spiritual man, I make intercession. Thank God for Sister Ann Harris coming on. God bless you. See, because we don't know everything we ought to pray for. So Jude say, when you pray in the spirit or pray in tongues, are you listening to me? You building up your most holy faith. So every day you ought to try to get in your closet, pray in your prayer language that God will build your faith. 2022, let me go just a little bit further. You know what the Bible say about faith? The Bible say he that cometh to God must first believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder to them that diligently seek him. So God said, you need to diligently seek him. And then he'll reward you for what you're seeking him for. Now catch this, 2022. Don't just only mean balance. Doesn't just only mean faith. It also means success. And so that's the reason why I came teaching, preaching, and telling people that 2022 is the year of upgrade. Mm-hmm. Thank God for Sister Clara Franklin. Amen. I was glad to see. Let your husband Pat know I was glad to see him, your sons. Amen. Let them know we just was elated to see you all. Next time I come to Dallas, Texas to preach, tell Pat I want to see him and all them boys at the house of God. All right. All right. I'm just sending love out to Fort Worth, Texas. We were just at a wedding the other day. And so many people are all over this country. They know me. And I know a lot of people. But anyway, I'm not on here to talk about that. But this family here is very dear to me, the whole family. And their mother is so precious. Amen. We just love a mother. Amen. Now, let me get back to this lesson. 2022. It also means success. So I believe that God is trying to bring us to a place of success. And I think that this is our year for success. Are you with me? Because when I look at what it means success. Now, in order for you to have success, I want you to write the scripture down, go back and study your devotional time. In order for you to have success, I want you to write down Joshua chapter 1, verse number 7. Joshua chapter 1, verse number 7. Because this is the word that God gave to Joshua. And I want to give this word to you. Only be thou strong and very courageous if you're going to have success. I'm probably not going to be able to finish this today. Because, you know, our lesson, what we're teaching on pastors, pastors need to be teaching their people, their congregation, to have success. Not just be saved, but be successful in everything they do. All right, only be thou strong and very courageous. If you're going to be successful, you have to be courageous. He said that thou mayest observe to do according to the law. If you're going to be successful, you have to obey the word of God. Turn not from it to the right hand or to the left, that thou mayest prosper whithersoever thou goest. Now catch this, because we understand that we're no longer under the law, under the Mosaic law. But that does not mean that we could do anything that we want to do, live any way we want to live. Because the Bible says sin stinks in God's nostrils. So we're going to be successful. We have to take this word, hide in our heart, be obedient to what the word says. That's the only way we're going to spiritually evolve. Obey this word. Now, Joshua 1:7 out the Living Bible say, you need only to be strong and courageous and to obey to the letter every law Moses gave you. For if you're careful to obey every one of them, you'll be successful in everything that you do. Now, we realize that in this day and age, we're not saved by the law. We are saved by grace. But we yet have to be obedient to what the word of God says. Because the Bible says that the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life. So God say, first of all, be strong, be courageous, observe to do the law. Don't turn from what you've been taught out of the word of God. Then he said, whithersoever thou goest, thou gonna prosper. Now, let's go just a little bit further. Verse number 8. The book of this of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that thou mayest observe to do according to all that's written therein. For then shalt thou make thy way prosperous, and then shalt thou have good success. It's time for me to quit because I'm getting tired talking. Now catch this. Verse number 80 tells us that the law, the book of the law, the word of God, shall not depart out of thy mouth, but meditate therein day and night. When you meditate on this word, you're going to stop having nightmares. Meditate on this word, you're going to stop having bad dreams. When you meditate on this word, he said day and night, get so consumed with this word and constantly. Amen. Sister Clara, God bless y'all and y'all have a safe trip. Amen. Tell Brother Pat, we're praying for y'all to have a safe trip and enjoy y'all vacation. I'm glad you put that on the screen. They're getting on the plane, headed to Orlando right now. All right, now, I need y'all to catch this. Because when we obey the word of God, when we meditate on this word day and night, are you with me? He says you're going to make your way prosperous and you're going to have good success. So I want to pick this up again tomorrow. Stay with me. I hope y'all got something out of this today. I want to pick this up again tomorrow. And I want to pick up tomorrow dealing with the year of upgrade. Because 2022, when you realize what it means in the natural sense, and you apply the word of God to it, and then you gonna find yourself walking, living a successful and a prosperous life. You need to declare it over your life right now. All right, thank God for the band that showed up, the leaders in prayer. And once again, the music you're playing in the background, we do not own the rights to this music. Into the hands of the band is Deborah Jean King.
Hello, everyone. How y'all doing out there today? Hopefully and pray to God all is well. Praise the Lord. Sister Clara, y'all have a safe trip. Amen. Love you, love you, love you. God, I come today repenting for everything in me, God, that's not like you. I ask you even now, God, that you would destroy it at the root, the very core and cause of it. Create within me, God, a clean heart. Renew within me a right spirit. That my prayers would not only be heard, God, but they would be answered. I thank you, Lord God, for being a keeper of my mind, my body, my soul, God. And I thank you, Lord God, for life, health, and strength. I praise you today, God, for our leaders. I thank you, Lord God, for all that you're doing for them in their lives. I ask you to continue to bless them, keep them, meet every need in their lives, oh God, in the name of Jesus. And any spirit that try to come against them, that's not like you, Lord God, we come against it even now, God. It have no power, it have no dominion over their minds, their body, nor their soul, God. We thank you, Lord God, for all the leaders out there listening, Lord God, that preaching and teaching, Lord God, your will, God. We ask you, Lord God, continue to bless them, keep them, add to their ministry such as you see fit, oh God. I thank you, Lord God, for Bishop Daniel, First Lady Daniel, Bishop Brooks, First Lady Brooks, Lord God. I thank you, Lord God, for Bishop Boyd, Keith, and Kevin, Lord God. I ask you, Lord God, bless their family, Lord God. Give them a peace, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, God. We thank you for all those who have lost loved ones. We ask you to continue, Lord God, do a work in their lives, oh God. We thank you for your grace, your mercy, your long suffering, God, that you're showing throughout our lives, oh God. We thank you, Lord God, for all those that's going on vacation, Lord God. We ask you, Lord God, that you would keep them, oh God. Let no death come nigh unto them, Lord God. While they're out there, let them go there safe and bring them back home safe in the name of Jesus. We thank you right now, God, for our bishop standing on the wall, God, and not taking down, God. We praise you, Lord God, for his life, oh God. We ask you even now, Lord God, that the saints of God will continue to lift him up in the name of Jesus as he give unto us spiritual things, God. We ask you, Lord God, open doors, Lord God, that we will be able to give unto him natural, Lord God. We praise you right now for the increase in everyone's life that given into his life and into our ministry. We ask you to bless them even the more. Meet every need in their lives, God. We thank you. We praise you. We honor you, Lord God, for all our grandchildren and children getting ready to go back to school. We ask you, Lord God, to let them have a great year, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Give them the teachers that they need, oh God, and that will show favor, Lord God, unto them, God. And we will give you praise, and we will give you honor, Lord God, in everything we say and do. In Jesus' name I pray on today. Amen and amen. In the hands of Bishop Nixon. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God.
I've come to tell somebody your life about to change, saint. Yes, y'all keep listening to this word and digesting this word. I say your life is about to change because God is changing your story. Brother Cal, God bless you, brother. Man, we haven't seen you in a minute, but we love you, man, and we appreciate you. And I just want to let you know, every one of y'all, that God is changing your story. He's releasing healing right now. He is changing your story. What? He's changing your story to what? That you're victorious. That nothing can conquer us because we are victorious. I say everything we do, we're going to be victorious. That's what I want to speak into your heart and your mind. That you are victorious. Catch this, catch this. We are victorious, sir. Catch this. We're in the middle of a battlefield. Nothing but victory on my mind. I'm never going to stop. I'm never going to yield. We are more than conquerors. Every time. God bless you, Brother K. Man, we'll be looking forward. Come down and fellowship with us. Amen. You know you don't need a place to stay when you come back home. Amen. We'll give you a place to stay. Bless you. You won't have to worry about getting a hotel room. Bless you. We love y'all. and we love you to life. In Jesus' name.